What's happening everyone, my name is Alex and welcome back. In today's video we are checking out one of the latest phones from Vivo. The one that we have here today, it's called the Vivo V30. Now in today's video we are specifically talking about the device's performance and the gaming performance. So I'm gonna show you some benchmark scores that we get for this device and I'm also gonna play some games so you can see how this device does for those things. Now, there is a lot more to this phone, of course, than the gaming performance and all that. For example, the screen here. What I really like about the screen is the screen brightness. So even though this is kind of like a mid-range device, it has a peak brightness of 2800 nits. So insanely bright screen for this device. Alright, so if we open the settings app here and go to about phone, you can see that inside this device we have the Snapdragon 7 Gen 3. This is in fact the first device that I got to try that's using this chipset. I also have the version that has 12 gigs of RAM and 512 gigs of internal storage. So this is pretty much the top of the line for the Vivo V30. Alright, if we open the AnTuTu benchmark here, we can see the score that we get for the AnTuTu benchmark, so about 833,000, but what's very interesting is the fact that the temperature of the device actually dropped while running this benchmark test. So that is very important because that means that the device is not gonna get super hot whenever you're playing games. If we go back here and we go to storage test, I can also show you the speeds that we get for the internal storage. Now, these are not the highest speeds out there, but for a mid-range device, I guess they are decent enough. And I can also show you the Geekbench 6 test that I've done. So here we get a multi-core score of about 3,200 and a single-core score of about 1,100. So overall, good performance, I'm gonna say, for a mid-range device. Alright, so next on the list we are going to be playing some games. We have PUBG, we have Genshin Impact, and we also have Call of Duty. Now for settings here, if we go to display, so I have the screen resolution set at the highest resolution available, and I also have the refresh rate set to 120Hz, just in case you're wondering. So we're going to start by playing Genshin Impact here first. Alright, so first things first, I have the FPS set to 60 frames per second, so that should give us the best experience with this game, I'm gonna say, and I also have this set to boost. So this is basically the best way to play games on this device if you have it set to boost. Okay, so we're gonna exit this and let's spin around for a bit. So really, really good for a mid-range device. I actually wasn't expecting this device would do this good for this game, because this is a very heavy game, very graphics intensive game, but it does seem to do quite well. Also, the screen is very responsive to touch, so really no complaints about this game here. Let me lower the volume a bit. So, really impressive performance for this particular game here. So yeah, this was a super quick look at how Genshin Impact would run on the Vivo V30. And the results are quite surprising, quite good, I'm gonna say. So I can't really say anything bad about the performance of this game right here. Alright, and next on the list we have Call of Duty, and for graphics I have everything set to high, just in case you're wondering, and once again we have this set to boost. So we'll go back here and I guess we'll play a multiplayer game and see how that goes. Alright, so maximum graphics settings as you'd expect, and yes, the device will do great for this game, no doubt about it. Because if it does great for the other game, of course it's gonna do great for this one. Unfortunately, I died, but we'll start again. So, really flawless performance for this as well. But unfortunately, they keep killing me, but the screen is very responsive. The phone doesn't feel hot quite yet, and I think I have about, machine gun. And I think I have about 45 minutes playing by now. between this game and the previous game. Take that. Alright, so let's move on to the next game. This one does work flawlessly. Alright, so for our last game, we are playing PUBG, and of course we have all the graphics settings at the maximum, and I do expect that this game will do good, just like the other two games. I mean, as soon as Genshin Impact does good for a phone, pretty much any other game that you're gonna be playing on that device will do great. So I do expect great performance from this game here as well. So we'll do a bit of running, a bit of spinning around, and as you can see, it is flawless. Okay, so let's find the weapon somewhere. We'll see if we have any luck. Oh, I think I've seen something here. All right. So now let's find someone. But what I wanted to show you is how the game performs. And as you can see for yourself, flawless performance once again. So I don't think there is any game that you're going to find that won't do good on the Vivo V30 here. So if you're looking for a phone that's not that expensive and that has great performance for gaming, this is definitely one to go for. Now, I did notice one thing, and that is the fact that the phone only has one speaker. So we only have one speaker at the bottom here. We don't actually have two speakers, and that is a bit disappointing. I was hoping they would have two speakers. I know that the last Vivo, the V29, only had one speaker, so I was kind of hoping this would get the second speaker, but I guess not. So that is one thing about this phone. Yeah, so for gaming performance, you can't really go wrong with that Snapdragon 7 Gen 3. So we'll exit this game here. The phone doesn't really feel that hot even after playing for, I don't know, 45 minutes, an hour now. Maybe it feels a bit warm around here, but realistically, it's not as hot as a flagship would get. So yeah, a very quick look at the Vivo V30 and the overall performance and the gaming performance. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.